Hi there, Gemini, and welcome back to Star-Lord is Tarot. This is your tarot forecast for the month of October. I went ahead, shuffled the cards, laid them all out. Let's see what's going on for Gemini. First up, we have Major Arcana, the Hierophant, in the upright, followed then by the Three of Wands upright. And next, we have Major Arcana, the Lovers, in the upright, followed then by the Six of Cups upright. And next we have the Queen of Wands in the upright, followed by the Four of Swords reversed. Next we have the Nine of Swords in the reverse, followed then by Major Arcana, the Magician. And next we have Major Arcana, the Moon reversed, followed then by the Two of Swords in the upright. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and interpret this read for you. First of all, Gemini, for your overall energy, you have Major Arcana, the Hierophant, in the upright position. The Hierophant mainly points to contracts and commitments and anything official. It could be for some of you, maybe you're committing to a love interest and perhaps you're taking your relationship to the next level, such as formal engagement or marriage. For others of you, you could be committing to a business partner or a business in general. Some of you could be committing to a new spiritual or religious group. Others of you could be signing a contract with perhaps a short-term contract with a school or a government, anything official like that. So this is covering your whole month. So interesting. It's all going to be about commitment this month for you, Gemini. And it's very progressive. Your crossing card is the Three of Wands in the upright position. Three of Wands is very progressive energy. This is where we've taken the initial idea, the initial, for some of you, the initial could have been a relationship. For others of you, could have been a business idea. It's going to be different for everyone because it is just a general read. But you've taken that and you've moved it from the very first initial idea, the initial spark, the initial manifestation, and you've managed to build it. It's at the three now. So you're just waiting for your ships to come in, that one more wand, and you will have arrived. So you're very, very progressive, it looks like, this month, Gemini. And in the past, this is something that could have played out a couple weeks ago, a couple months ago. We do have Major Arcana, the Lovers, the Gemini card in the upright position. So this is you having to make a choice or a decision about something. I did see this in the weekly for Gemini. So some of you were definitely dealing with needing to make a choice or a decision about something. Now, for some of you, this could have been playing out in their career, your work situation. Definitely others of you, it could have been on the romantic front. So there was a choice that was made, I guess, in the last couple of weeks for you, and you're now making a commitment to it. Interesting. And you're leaving the month of September and moving into October with the Six of Cups in the upright position. Aries got this in the same position as well. Maybe some of you are dealing with an Aries, and maybe there's someone from the past, because the Six of Cups is the Blast from the Past card. Beautiful energy. I do like it. It's very fair, balance on the emotional front. It's beautiful energy. This can point to sometimes someone from the past, that one that got away, returns again on the scene. For others of you, it's very soulmate kind of energy, where we're just clicking with someone. Could be someone from the past or someone that we just meet that feels like someone from the past, like a past life connection maybe. But there's a really strong connection here to the past. Maybe some of you are going to a family reunion or a high school reunion, or just getting together with friends or co-workers from the past. So that energy gives way in the early part of October to the Queen of Wands in the upright position, which was also in the Aries reading, and the Queen of Wands can represent an Aries. So some of you are definitely dealing with an Aries. And Queen of Wands in the upright position, does point to a fire sign. So this is a person, and the fire signs are Aries, as well as Leo, Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, male or female. So it could be that you're connecting with a fire sign, but it could be any sign. It could even be you embodying the energies of the Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands is a real go-getter, can indicate travel. Maybe you're moving about, maybe you're traveling in the early part of October, but whatever it is, you could be in businessman or woman mode, maybe just getting things done, getting things accomplished. Maybe some of you are looking to start a business or looking to move your offices or expand or do something like that. It's beautiful, beautiful progressive reading here we've got going on, Gemini. And around the middle of the month, we do see the Four of Swords here in the reverse position. The Four of Swords is all about, I'm done with the healing energy. I am healed. I am ready to get back into action again. So this is a return to action. This is a return to the land of the living. Four of Swords in the upright is when we're taking a time out to either heal our body, our mind, our emotions from a situation that caused a bit of a setback. But now we are ready, and how could you not be ready with all this progressive energy? You better be ready, Gemini. And how you could be feeling over the month of October, not necessarily the face you're showing to the world, but this is how you could be feeling internally. We do have the Nine of Swords reversed, which is beautiful. This is where you're finally going to get some good night's sleeps, I think, in October, Gemini, probably because things are moving along so beautifully. Nine of Swords in the upright, this is where we could be overthinking a situation. We're in our head too much. All these thoughts just ruminating around and around and around, causing a lot of worry, a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety. When the card is inverted, this is where we're being released from that energy. Probably because things are moving now. And, you know, when things start moving along, we have less time to ruminate in our head. We need to take action and we need to get our sleep in order to be able to be active during the day. So in our people and environment, we do see the Magician here in the upright position. The Magician is beautiful energy. I do love it in the upright. This is where we're, people could be seeing you, people in your environment could be seeing you this month, Gemini, as the Magician, someone who's manifesting, you know, some goals and getting things going and feeling very confident. Look at all that yellow there. And this is where we're able to manifest best when our confidence is high. And I do see that in this reading for you. So if that's not you being the Magician, it could be that you're dealing with other people in your environment who are just making things happen. And that's beautiful and almost kind of like magic, isn't it, Gemini? And in your hopes and fears position, we do see Major Arcana, the Moon, here in the reverse position. This is the Pisces card. The Moon in the upright can cause a lot of confusion and delusion and that type of thing. When the card is inverted, this is about all about clarity, seeing things for exactly what they are. So that's what you're hoping for. And I could see with such a progressive and action-packed month, Gemini, I can see where you would definitely want to have things laid out for you as clear as possible, because if you're going to be putting this kind of energy and attention into whatever it is you're building, whether it's a relationship or business or what have you, you want to absolutely have full clarity on the situation. And the last card you have up is the Two of Swords. I hate to leave this on a cliffhanger, but the Two of Swords definitely is going to be a cliffhanger. So you'll have to leave me a comment in the comment section below to let me know how this played out for you. Because at the very end of the month, there is a decision to be made. The Two of Swords here is in the upright position. So it looks like whatever, you've got a lot of momentum going on here in the month, Gemini. And, but at the end of the month, it looks like, boom, there's another decision. You just got over making a major decision, and now there's going to be another decision. The reason she has the blindfold on is because she feels she doesn't have enough information to make an informed decision at the very last. Now, this could be connected to whatever is going on here that you've made the commitment to, but this could be a separate thing. also too, because this comes up at the end of the month. So maybe now there's another situation. It's like, now that all this is happening, what do I do about that situation? Could be a side situation. It could be another element of the main situation and some of the main players that are involved in this. This month for you, Gemini. What an interesting reading. You'll definitely have to let me know what decision you make at the end of October here, because that's probably why in your hopes position you're hoping for clarity, because the Two of Swords needs extra clarity in order to make a final decision on something. And then, you know, once that decision comes through, then we can make the final decision. So that may not come to pass for you until November. So I hope this reading helped you, Gemini. If it did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Bye-bye for now.